Good morning, students. Good morning to all. And last day we have studied about the theories of wages, and in these theories many theories was there related to the wages. So today we will go to study about the theories of interest. So theories of interest. First we have to know about the meaning of interest. The generally the speaking, interest is a payment made by a borrower to the lender for the money borrowed. But in this economics, it has some separate or peculiar meaning. So interest is the reward paid by the borrower to a lender for the use of capital. We have studied already, so without having the capitals, we cannot improve our business organizations, and sometimes we cannot able to established the industries. So if you want to produce some amount of the commodities, we need one of the organization or the production unit. For that, the capital is also one of the important factors. So this interest also one of the distributive payment. By using the capital, or the capital will be getting the interest. The capital will get some of the reward in the form of interest. So interest is the price paid for the use of capital in any market. So some of the theories also is there too explaining the interest. First one of the theory is abstinence theory or waiting theory. This theory was propounded by N.W. Senior, according to whom interest is the reward for abstaining from the immediate consumption of wealth. Normally, if the persons, most of the persons want to consuming the present commodity, or most of the peoples want to consuming the immediate consumption of wealth. According to Senior, capital is the result of saving. Result of savings mean from where we will get the capital? By the way of savings only. Every month or every week or day by day, if you are saving some amount of money as a little by little, only we can get the capital. For the purpose of creating the more capital, the people's have to sacrifice their personal consumption or the present consumption, and they have to wait for creating the more capital by the way of the small savings. So according to the Senior, capital is the result of saving. By the way of the savings only, the bank or the individual persons can create or make the capital. If I have some amount of the savings only, another of the individual entrepreneur or any of the producers can get the capitals. So the peoples can get the reward for waiting the savings. But saving involves abstinence or sacrifice. If you want to have more savings mentality, we have to know the sacrificing for the present consumption. We have to reduce our consumption. Because of that only, we can get more savings. So it is possible to save only if one abstains from present consumption. If you are leaving the present consumption, and if that amount is going to the savings only, we will get more capital. But all the peoples will not able to having the savings mentality. Always when we have some amount of the money, we want to spend for the consumption, the present consumption. But some of the peoples will sacrifice their present savings, present consumption, and he will get the more propensity to save. So by the way of having the propensity to save, that people must be get the reward in the form of interest. So such abstinence from present consumption involves some sufferings, because mostly we cannot fulfill our basic necessity of life. Otherwise, we cannot consume any of the luxury commodities or the comfortable commodities. If you are abstinent to the present consumption of the luxury goods or the comfortable goods only, we can get the more propensity to savings, and because of that only we can get the more capitals. So hence it is necessary to reward the saver. Saver means the capitalist or the producer, they are the individual persons. So to compensate for the sacrifice he has to undergo by abstaining from present consumption. For sacrificing the present consumption, the individual people can get some of the reward in the form of interest. So therefore, interest is the reward or compensation paid to the saver for his abstinence or sacrifice. For the purpose of sacrificing the present consumption, that saver can get the some reward. So that reward only is considered as a interest. If you are saving more than your present consumption, you are sacrificing your present consumption, then you are the sacrificer, then you must get the reward. The reward only is considered as a interest. So Marshall accepted the abstinence theory of interest, but he used the word waiting instead of abstinence, because we can say waiting and the abstinence, because if you want to get the more capital, we have to take the abstinence and we have to being as waiting. So saving implies waiting. According to him, interest is the reward for the waiting. So saving involves waiting, because if you are waiting for creating the more capital, we must wait. So little by little amount, if you are saving only, if you are saving the little by little amount only, we can create the more capital. So we have to sacrifice some of the present consumption, and we have to save, and we have to wait for making that small saving as a big capital. So but people do not like to wait. So in order to make them wait and intend to save, we have to pay them some reward. Normally, if the people are not getting any of the reward for the purpose of their waiting, they will never get the interest to wait. But if they are getting some of the reward for the purpose of waiting the money or waiting for the capital, they will get the interest and they will wait for making the capital. So therefore, interest is the reward paid to the saver for his waiting. If individual persons want to create any capitals, they have to wait till the savings become as a large capital. So if you are giving some of the interest, they will get the desire to savings and they will ready to being waiting. But this theory has one of the criticism. So according to this theory, saving involves suffering, but savings may not always involve suffering to some rich people. Some of the poor people only have to abstinence or have to sacrifice their present consumption, then only they can able to savings. But the rich people is not like that. Even if they are not sacrificing their present consumption, they can make their savings more. So rich people have money for which they do not get interest. Hoarding of money is to quench the thirst for liquidity. So most of the rich people will hoarding their money without getting the interest. The poor people only will have the interest to savings, and because of that they can sacrifice some of the present consumption. Next theory, the time preference theory. This theory also will be equal or will be like as a abstinence theory only. This theory was propounded by John Dray in 1834. But credit goes to the Bohm Bawerk, an Austrian school economist, who has given final shape to the theory. The American economist Irving Fisher modified and gave a new theory for the time preference theory. According to this theory, people prefer present goods rather than future goods. Normally, most of the people will want to consume the present only. They will never expect and they will never wait for the future consumptions. Because the present goods are more certain than the future goods. Tomorrow, we will never know, we will get the possibilities and the chances for doing something and receiving something. But if you are getting something in the present, we will get it and we will consume. So there are many countries where no one knows what will happen next day. The Asian crisis of 1996 and American crisis of 2007 and 2008 were not predicted even for economists, including Nobel laureates. So people always get the discerners to consuming the present commodities and the present goods only. They will never wait for the future goods. So when people say they have to postpone their present enjoyment or satisfaction. But even though some of the people will get the savings, and because of that they will wait for the saving, become as a more capital. If one postpones one's present satisfaction, one has to be paid an agio or premium. When one is going to saving the money, another one is use that money for their present satisfaction, present consumption. So here one of the persons have to sacrifice their present consumption, then only another persons can able to consuming the present goods. So the people who is going to consuming the present good, he has to pay the saver. He has to pay the reward to the saver. So this premium is interest. So people prefer present consumption than future consumption due to the risk increasing and uncertainty of the present world. We will never know tomorrow we will be live or not. Tomorrow can we go to the particular place or not. So we will never know what will happen on tomorrow. So most of the people want to living their life within the present itself. But if they are not having the sufficient lot of the money, they will borrow the money from the other persons. But that persons also has the desire to consuming the present goods, but they will sacrifice. So once going to sacrifice their present consumption only, another one can able to consuming the present goods. Next, loanable fund theory. So the loanable fund theory also loanable fund theory. So the loanable fund theory was developed by Swedish economists like Wicksell, Bertil, Åhlin, Weiner and Myrdal. So according to this theory, interest is the price paid for the use of loanable funds. Some of the funds always will be there for the purpose of loan, giving the loans. The rate of interest is determined by the equilibrium between the demand for and the supply of loanable funds in the credit market. So if you want to have the more capital, some of the supply of currencies also have to be there and the demand also will be there. If the demand for money is more than the supply of money, mean what will happen? the rate of interest will be increased. So the rate of interest will be going to determined by the equilibrium between the demand for and the supply of loanable funds. The interest is the price paid for the use of loanable funds. How much amount or how we are using the loanable funds, we have to pay some of the reward as a interest. So the demand for loanable funds depend upon some of the following factors. So when the demand is more, the demand for the money is more than the supply of money, the rate of interest will be increasing on the basis of the law of demand. So the demand for loanable funds also will be depending upon the three factors. For whatever reasons, the demand for loanable funds will be there. First, the demand for investment. The most important factor responsible for the loanable fund is the demand for investment. Most of the people or most of the entrepreneur have to make the investment on their production unit, on their organizations. But when they don't have the sufficient level of the fund, they want to borrow the money from any of the bank or any of the individual persons. But the purpose is make the investment. So for the purpose of investment, the loanable fund always will be as a demand. So bulk of the demand for loanable funds come from the business firms which borrow money for purchasing capital goods. So most of the producers or the entrepreneurs will be in need of more fund, loanable fund, for the purpose of purchasing the raw materials and the capital goods. Anyway, it will be considered as a investment. So the demand for investment, we will be need of fund. Next, demand for consumption. So the demand for loanable funds comes from the individuals who borrow money for consumption purposes also. So every individual person also will be in the need of having some amount of the money for the consumption purposes. Some of the peoples will not be as a, some of the peoples will be there without having the employment opportunity, but they have to fulfill their basic necessity of life and they have to spend for their comfortable life or the educational fees and some of the more purposes. So for the purpose of consumption also, the fund will be needed. So the demand for the consumption also, the loanable fund will be there. Next, demand for hoarding. So the next demand for the loanable fund comes from the hoarders. So they will be protect their money without having any of the accounts. So the demand for hoarding money arises because of people's preference for the liquidity, idle cash balances and so on. So normally most of the people get the interest to holding the money in their hand itself without having any of the accounts. Even though if they have more money in their bank, they will get the interest to holding the money in their hand itself as a liquidity. The demand for consumption, investment and hoarding varies inversely with the interest rate. For the purpose of the three, above three, the interest rate will be varied. The demand for investment, if the people are getting the capital, the investment, the interest rate may be reduce or low. For the demand for the consumption, if the people are getting the money, they will get the different type of the interest. And the supply of loanable fund also depending upon some of the factors. From wherever we can get the possible to supply the loanable funds. Again, first one, savings. The loanable funds come from savings. According to this theory, savings may be of two types, namely savings planned by individuals are called ex ante savings. For example, LIC premium, EMI pay and etc. will considered as a savings planned individuals. So for the future purposes or some of the purposes only, they will make the savings from the LIC or any of the EMI payment. Next, the unplanned savings are called exposed savings. Saving is left out after spending in exposed savings. So after over the consumption for their daily life, we will have some of the amount of money. So this money will going to the savings. So anyway, the savings only is the important factor to increasing the supply of money or supply of loanable funds. Next, bank credit. The bank credit is another source of loanable funds. Commercial banks create credit and supply loanable funds to the investors. So now all the individual peoples and all the entrepreneurs, producers or any of the wholesalers will be approached as a commercial banks only, because the bank will providing the credit facilities for their members or for their customers, and even the individual entrepreneurs can get the possible to borrowing the money from the bank. So next, discounting money. The discounting means bringing out the hoarded money into use, and thus it constitutes as a source of supply of loanable funds. Suppose if they are more possible to earning the profit, so many of the peoples will bringing out the hoarded money into the use of making investment. So the discounting money is also one of the factor of supply of loanable funds. In India, after 1991, public sector undertakings are being sold to private people to mobilize more funds. This is also called disinvestment. So disinvestment means, disinvestment is the opposite of investment. So the peoples will not able to or will not having the interest to making the investment, and that amount will come out to the use of other peoples. In other words, the disinvestment means not providing sufficient funds for depreciation of equipment. It gives rise to the supply of loanable funds. So all the four sources of supply of loanable funds vary directly with the interest rate. So here also the peoples will get the different interest rate from wherever they are getting the fund. So now the loanable fund will determining the rate of interest. When the rate of interest is determined by the equilibrium between the demand for and supply of loanable funds. So here the demand for investment, the demand for consumption, the demand for hoarding money is equal to the savings and the bank credit and the discounting and the disinvestment. Suppose if the supply and the demand for the money is equilibrium, we will get the reasonable rate of interest. Otherwise, if the demand for the loanable fund is more than the supply of loanable fund, so the interest rate will be determined as higher. So in this theory also, we have some of the criticism. So many factors have been included in this theory. Still, there are many more factors. Two such factors are asymmetric information and the moral hazards. In practice, larger firms, due to their political powers, are able to get huge bank credit at the lower interest rate. But due to non-performing assets, small firms and depositors lost their interest income. The loanable funds theory is the indeterminate unless the income level is already known. Next, it is very difficult to combine real factors like savings and investment with monetary factors like bank credit and liquidity preference. because most of the people will not able to make the investment on any of the production purposes instead of depositing in the bank. Okay students, it's enough I think. If you have any doubt, please ask me, and just you take the theory of interest. So the abstinence theory and the preference theory as your study portions. Thank you.